status check to proceed with terminal count.
There is a moment at the start of every mission when everything comes together. A moment when years of preparation and planning are put to the test.
Clear to proceed.
There are no second chances.
You have permission to launch.
Success or failure is just a heartbeat away.
Rocket for range status.
Range green.
A spacecraft and its rocket on the pad, fully fueled and ready to launch.
Status check.
Go Atlas. Go
Centaur.
In that moment, a controlled explosion is released with such intense power, it can propel a spacecraft off the Earth and into space for the benefit of all. We call this moment T-Zero. This is its story. NASA is about to do something we've never done before. Nestled along the mountains on California's Central Coast is a little talked about space launch center known as Vandenberg Air Force Base. From here, history is about to be made.
This is the first time we've had an interplanetary launch from Vandenberg Air Force Base in California. The cool thing about this launch is that we've got such a capable rocket, the Atlas V, we don't have to launch from Florida.
Oh, InSight is going to be the first time that we've had a spacecraft leave Earth's orbit launching from California. We've actually done studies for it, even up to decades ago, but it just comes down to whether or not the mission had extra propellant left over and whether there was an operational reason to switch from an East Coast launch to a West Coast. This is just the first time all of it came together.
What we're gonna do is we're gonna unload the spacecraft really, really carefully, and then we're gonna drive it a couple of miles to the Astrotech facility where they have a clean room all set up for us. Got about 2 months here. All we gotta do is clean it up, test it out, put the fuel in the tanks and bolt it on the rocket, and off we go to Mars.
InSight is NASA's next groundbreaking mission, literally designed to break ground on Mars. Using probes and seismometers, InSight will listen for Mars quakes and measure how much heat the planet's interior gives off. If we're going to truly understand how rocky planets like Mars and Earth were created, we need to look inside.
It's unlike other missions that we've done at Mars. We have a number of orbiters, a number of landers that we've successfully explored this amazing planet. But this actually is the first mission where we're really looking on the inside, the inner space of Mars.
Sending a science mission to the Red Planet is never easy. Landing a probe on the surface is even harder. To accomplish this, InSight will have to shed its many components in a matter of minutes, bit by bit, like peeling an orange, until only the lander is left.
So the crew stage itself is the critical component that actually gets us to Mars. There's an aeroshell that absorbs the heat as we re-enter the atmosphere. That aeroshell enables us to go through the atmosphere of Mars successfully without getting the inside, the lander itself, too hot. We deploy a parachute. That parachute does two things. It really ensures the stability of the aeroshell as it's starting to get closer to the surface. It also slows down the spacecraft further until finally we drop out of the combination back shell and parachute, and then we do a propulsive descent down to the surface.
We know water exists on Mars, and where there's water, there could be signs of life. But we must ensure any organisms we discover weren't simply stowaways from Earth. This is where the Planetary Protection Team comes into play.
Planetary protection is what we do to responsibly explore other planets and moons in our solar system. In order to do that, we need to make sure that we send a clean spacecraft there. We would hate to get to another planet or moon and think we discovered life, but it was actually something that we brought with us. So we collect our samples on InSight, any part of InSight that's going to land on the surface of Mars. We bring it back to our lab and we process it using a NASA procedure. If we run into a situation where we take a sample and it comes back as having a higher number of bacteria than what we want, then we make sure that the engineers go back and clean those surfaces with the whole idea that we don't want to cloud our ability to potentially find life on another planet or moon.
Lockheed Martin Space of Denver, Colorado, built InSight with an extremely efficient design, streamlining what needs to be done at the launch site. They ship the spacecraft to Vandenberg with no assembly required. Simply check it out, fuel it, test it, encapsulate it, and it's ready for launch.
The processing for our spacecraft has been very smooth. A lot of the processing had to do with fueling the spacecraft, removing some removed before flight items. Everything else was pretty much already installed on the spacecraft in Denver, Colorado before it was shipped here. And that's called a ship and shoot, which means there's not too much to do except for to fuel the vehicle and do some last minute power on checkouts of the onboard computers and subsystems.
These preparations are crucial. Everything must be working perfectly before InSight leaves Earth. This effort is designed to ensure a safe arrival and landing following the six-month trip from Earth to Mars. In the meantime, United Launch Alliance, or ULA, is busy at their launch pad, Slick 3, assembling the world's most successful rocket, the Atlas V.
Well, I mean, we're building a rocket. What's not exciting about that? And really excited to be able to launch the first planetary mission from the West Coast.
First, ULA stacks their Atlas V booster onto the launch platform. Atlas V is powered by the mighty RD-180 rocket engine. The RD-180 is a powerhouse, burning highly refined kerosene known as RP-1 and liquid oxygen for thrust. For this mission, the RD-180 has more than enough power to get InSight off of Earth and heading towards Mars. When the booster's fuel is spent, the Centaur second stage kicks in and finishes the job. Centaur won't actually hit Mars. It will fly just past it. Final course corrections will be done by InSight itself to enter the Martian atmosphere and land on the surface. Once fueling and testing is complete, the team from United Launch Alliance will encapsulate InSight inside its payload fairing, the shell that keeps InSight clean and safe during its dangerous ascent through Earth's atmosphere.
We're at the phase of the mission where we're encapsulating with the launch vehicle, and the ULA team with their fairings now come in and they take the two halves of the fairings and they make a clamshell around the spacecraft to help protect it for the environments that we see during launch. And we do that because as we leave the Earth's atmosphere, the air and the molecules in the atmosphere would tear up our spacecraft otherwise, and the fairing is there to protect us.
With InSight encapsulated in its fairing, it's time to move the payload out to Slick 3. But this California coastline comes with its own set of challenges. The surrounding marine layer can swallow up a launch pad, reducing visibility to under a couple hundred feet.
So right now, it's on the transport vehicle and it's ready to roll. And we'll be rolling out around 2 a.m. At that point, we'll have a convoy that drives very slowly from the payload processing facility out to the Slick 3 Atlas V facility. And once it arrives, we'll hoist the encapsulated spacecraft up to the top of the mobile service tower and place it on the launch vehicle.
This morning when it was sitting on the truck and they put the crane on it, they started lifting it up. That's the last time this spacecraft's ever gonna feel the ground of Earth. I'm just kind of jumping out of my skin. This is so exciting. We're getting so close to launch and it's been a long, long road for me. This has been a challenging program. I mean, we've had a lot of technical issues to overcome. So we actually had to stand down back in 2015. But since then, we've gotten it all together and things have been going so smoothly the last year. We really feel really confident about this launch now. We got it on top of the rocket. We're gonna blast it off in just a few days. And when it gets to Mars and lands, finally, it'll have solid ground under its feet again and get to work on probing the depths of Mars.
But InSight won't be traveling alone. Hitching a ride to the Red Planet are a pair of CubeSats, twin satellites called Marco A and Marco B.
So Marco is a dual payload riding as a secondary mission on its way to Mars.
So Marco is a pair of CubeSats, and CubeSats are really small spacecraft. They're essentially the size of a large cereal box, so about this big.
It's going to be relaying telemetry from the entry, descent, and landing of InSight back to Earth in near real time. After InSight is deployed on orbit and is heading to Mars, Centaur, which is behind me, ejects Marco A into orbit, and it'll slowly rotate itself so that Marco B ejects 180 degrees on the other side of the vehicle.
But Mako is a technology demonstration mission. It's actually one of the smallest spacecraft we've ever launched into planetary space. It's the first interplanetary CubeSat. So in of itself, it has all of these technology that we've never tested in deep space before. So if Mako works this time, one of the cool things that we could do is actually replicate that system and fly it with other missions in the future. And whether you're going to Mars or Venus or maybe even further away to an asteroid, you could think of it as bring your own telecom relay.
So everything went well today with the lift of the spacecraft and mate onto the rocket. It started off very foggy and windy, and right now it's a beautiful day, this typical California weather. And now we're ready to go to Mars.
But just as twilight falls across the base, the fog returns, cloaking the coast with a bone-chilling mist that will last until daybreak.
As we get closer to T0, liftoff time, a number of activities have to happen. There's a mobile service tower around the Atlas V rocket, and the InSight spacecraft is on top of the rocket, enclosed in the payload fairing. So we're going to back that mobile service tower away from the rocket to leave it exposed just beside the umbilical tower.
Stand engineer, proceed with MST roll to park position.
Roger.
MST bores shall be closed in park position.
Roger.
The final launch pad preparation is underway. Once the mobile service tower is rolled back, InSight and Atlas V are just hours away from T0. Basking in the searchlights of the West Coast facility, they are presented with the glamour of a Hollywood premiere, fitting treatment for such an historical mission.
So there's a lot of excitement within the NASA launch team about the InSight mission. First time we're going to launch from the California coast, going to Mars. And what is really exciting to the team is this is the culmination of a lot of work. The teams have been working on this mission for over 5 years, and today is the day that they will see all of their hard work rewarded.
Status check to proceed with terminal count, Atlas systems, propulsion.
Go.
Hydraulics.
Go.
Pneumatics.
Go.
LO2.
Go.
Water.
Go.
Centaur systems, propulsion.
Go.
Pneumatics.
Go.
LH2.
Go.
Facility.
Go.
Range coordinator.
Clear to proceed.
Launch director.
LC, you have permission to launch.
Go Atlas.
Go Centaur.
Go InSight. Proceeding with the count.
We're at T-minus 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 0. And liftoff of the Atlas V. Launching the first interplanetary mission from the West Coast. And NASA's InSight, the first outer space robotic explorer to study the interior of Mars.
Seconds after liftoff, the rocket punches through the marine layer, lighting the night sky for miles, visible all the way down to Los Angeles. An infrared camera showing the long tail of the exhaust plume captures some of the ascent, as well as an onboard ascent camera.
And we're nearing booster engine cutoff, or BECO.
Back to 4.6 Gs in preparation for BECO. Boost phase cooldown has completed. And we have BECO. Shutdown looks good. Stage separation. We have box and fuel pre-start. GN2 purge firing. The RCS is underway. We have ignition and full thrust. And we have indication of payload fairing jettison. Looks like a good step.
And the payload fairing that was encapsulating the InSight spacecraft has been jettisoned. The RL-10C engine, the second stage of the Centaur, continues to burn.
An hour and 28 minutes into the mission, the InSight spacecraft and the Mako twins are deployed from the Centaur upper stage, beginning the long voyage to Mars, where InSight will go to work shedding light on secrets hidden in the depths of the Red Planet.
T-minus 3.
Engine start.
2. 1.